क्लोज अप करते हैं।
Stream it on the internet.
Stream? But this is not a smart TV.
Oh God. You know, you can turn any TV into a smart TV these days, Mrs. Flintstone.
Mrs. Flintstone, mat kaho na.
We'll have a gay old time.
Hi guys, you're watching Tech It Out with me, Aditya. Are you also still living in the prehistoric era with the Flintstones just because your TV is not a smart TV? Well, worry not, because in today's video, I'm going to show you how to turn any TV into a smart TV just like that. And I promise you that once you've learned this, you won't even remember the last time you switched your set-top box on. So, let's check it out. So smart TVs have become really popular and affordable lately with the introduction of brands like Xiaomi that launched its Mi TV, you know, smart TV at a great price of 12,999 when everybody else was selling their smart TVs at a much higher cost. Ever since then, a lot of other brands have also introduced their own smart TVs which are cheap and affordable, with the latest entrant being Sammy Informatics, which is a Delhi-based company that launched its smart TV at an unbelievable price of 4,999. Although it might cost you somewhere around 8,000 bucks to, you know, get the TV in your hands with shipping and tax and all those other things. But a lot of us bought TVs back when this whole smart TV race had not begun. And those TVs work just fine. They have great picture quality, they have good sound, they have everything else that we need except for the smart TV capabilities. So what are we to do? How are we to add smart TV capabilities to a non-smart TV? Well, the most common way of doing that is going out and buying a Google Chromecast or an Amazon Fire TV stick and just plugging that into your TV and start watching Netflix or Amazon Prime or Hotstar, any of those other services on your TV right away. But what if we don't want to limit ourselves to just watching Amazon Prime and Netflix and Hotstar? What if we want to be able to stream anything off the internet? How do we do that? Well, as it turns out, there's a quick and easy way to do just that. Let me show you how. So once you have all those things in place, the first thing you want to do is grab your memory card and your memory card reader and head to the computer and flash the smart TV software onto the memory card. Let's do that.
First, head to the LibreElec website link given in the description and navigate yourself to the downloads page of the website. From the downloads page, select the operating system that you're using, either Windows or Mac. I'm on a Mac, so I'll choose Mac. Once the file has finished downloading, simply open the installer and install the software onto your computer. Next, plug in the memory card into your computer and then go ahead and open the newly installed software, which is LibreElec installer. Once the software is running, under Select Version, select the correct version of Raspberry Pi that you own. I own the Raspberry Pi 3, so I'll choose that option. Next, choose the latest version of LibreElec from the drop-down menu. Right now it's 9.0, so I'll select that. Once you've selected all those options, just press Download and select a location for the file to download. By this time, the file should have started downloading, and it usually takes about 2 or 3 minutes to download, but depending on your internet connection speed, it might take you a little longer or a little lesser time to download. Once the file finishes downloading, you now need to select your memory card from the drop-down menu at number 3. Make sure that you choose the memory card that you intend to use for this build, because whatever you choose in this section will be completely erased. So be very careful while selecting the memory card. And once you've carefully selected the right disk at step number 3, simply press write at step number 4 and wait for the software to be written onto your memory card. And once that's done, simply quit the running application, eject your memory card from your computer and follow the rest of the tutorial.
Now that your memory card is all set up and ready to go, all you want to do is grab your Raspberry Pi, insert the memory card into the Raspberry Pi and continue setting it up.
Once you've inserted the memory card into the Raspberry Pi and switched it on for the first time, the Raspberry Pi will ask you to do some basic setup like language preference and internet connection, etc., etc. The whole process is pretty straightforward and very basic, so go ahead and finish that up and continue on to the next segment.
Now, once you finish setting up the basic things on it, the next thing to do is install Amazon Prime and Netflix onto it.
From the home screen, scroll down to Add-ons, then scroll down to Download, then scroll all the way down to Video Player Input Stream. Now select the first option, which is Input Stream Adaptive, and press Install. Once that's installed, just go back by hitting the backspace. Now scroll all the way up to Add-on Repository. Then select Kodi Nerds Add-ons and hit Install. Once that's installed, scroll down to Netflix Add-on Repository and hit Install. Next, scroll down to Sandman79's Repository and hit Install again. Once that's installed, just press Backspace to go back and then once more to go back again. Now scroll down to Install from Repository. Then scroll down to Sandman79's Repository, then Video Add-ons, then select Amazon VOD and press Install. At this screen, simply press OK to install all the other add-ons that Amazon requires to work automatically. Once Amazon VOD has been installed, just press back to go back one step and then press back again to go back once more. Then scroll up to Netflix Add-on Repository, then Video Add-ons, and then select Netflix and hit Install again. At the version selection screen, select the latest version available. And again at this screen, simply press OK to install all the additional add-ons that Netflix requires to run. Once it's installed, you're all set to sit back, relax, and enjoy Netflix and Amazon Prime on your non-smart TV with a Raspberry Pi. The first time you start Netflix, it's going to ask you for your username and password, so go ahead and fill that in. And once you fill that in, choose a user from the user selection screen and then go ahead and choose some content that you'd like to play. I'm going to go ahead and select Shark Tank and show you how that looks in just about a moment. Now when you get this pop-up about Widevine, just go ahead and select Install Widevine and wait for it to be installed. And once that's done, we're good to go.
So with that, we've got Netflix and Amazon Prime Video running on a non-smart TV. But what about streaming all those other goodies from the internet? Well, let me show you how that's done.
Head to the Quasar link given in the description and scroll down to where it says Downloads. Under Downloads, click the link that says Releases, and that should get you to this page. Now scroll down and find the link that says linux_armv7.zip and click on that link to download the file. Once the file has finished downloading, simply copy the downloaded file onto a pen drive, then insert that pen drive into the Raspberry Pi and follow the rest of the process there. On your Raspberry Pi, navigate to Add-ons, then navigate to Download, then press backspace once to go back, then scroll down to install from zip file. Now choose your pen drive from the pop-up menu and then select the zip file that we downloaded earlier and let it install. Once it's finished installing, you should see a pop-up that says download path not set, check your settings. Simply press OK at this pop-up. Now select download path and go ahead and select a directory where you want all the media files to be downloaded and saved. Now press OK, and once you do that, you should see a pop-up like this about Quasar Burst. simply go ahead and say yes and let it finish installing. Once that's done, that's it. You're done setting everything up and now it's time to go and see it in action. So let's see how it works.
Turn any TV into a smart TV. Now I hope you enjoyed my video and you liked my video. If you did, then do let me know by hitting that like button down below. And if there's anything that you'd like to say to me, about my content, about anything else in the world, then feel free to chat up in the comment section below. And if you want to watch more videos like this, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And also hit that bell icon to get notified every time I put up a new video. If you'd like to keep in touch with me on other social platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, etc., etc., then all those links will be down in the description. And yeah, that's about it, guys. That's it for today. And I'll see you soon in my next video. But until then, keep teching it out.